this video, we will be demonstrating the discharge over a notch experiment, the H6 from TecQuipment. This allows students to carry out tests on relationships between upstream water levels and weir discharge for various different shape notches for a greater practical understanding of head against discharge and the coefficient of discharge for notches. Weirs are used for many reasons in civil engineering, whether it's simply to raise the level of upstream water in a river or a canal system, to retain fish stocks in a section of river, or generally to regulate flow in rivers and other open channels. Weirs have different shapes and designs, which work better for different applications. The most common include broad-crested, sharp-edged or sharp-crested, or weirs that have a shaped notch. Let's take a closer look around the apparatus. The main area is a molded tank that simulates the upstream at this end that is wide and the downstream at this end that is narrower and deeper. This middle section forms a channel. Five weir plates are supplied that fit into the sealed groove in the channel section. Two V-shaped notch weirs, a trapezoidal Cipoletti weir, a linear head flow weir, and a rectangular notch weir. The whole experiment sits upon TecQuipment's hydraulic bench that's available to purchase separately. The hose from the bench supplies the water to the wide end of the tank, where it then flows through the channel, over the weir, and where the deep tank exit allows students to see the discharge. Students measure the free water surface using an adjustable depth gauge attached to a beam across the channel. The tank outlet sits over the end here in the ledge of the bench. To sit on top, there's this depth gauge that I mentioned a moment ago, and a fixing point that can be thumb screwed into place. Now let's talk about performing the experiments. We recommend at least two people work together, with one person taking the weir readings and the other to check the flow rates and be prepared for splashes of water. Set up like this, making sure the upstream water is at the bottom of the notch, there's a small beaker supplied in case you need to add or remove water from the upstream to get this spot on. Now, carefully adjust the depth gauge so that it touches the tip of the surface of the water. The first experiment allows students to study the flow and head relationship in all of the weirs. We'll show you how to do one of these in a separate experiment video. The second experiment shows you how to calculate flow from the upstream head using the constants found in the earlier experiments. This is one of the many experiment modules available for use with the digital hydraulic bench. For more information about the discharge over a notch experiment, click on the links below. Thanks for watching.